Hey guys, I'm Erin with Remote Work Guides, where we help you rock working online. And in today's video, I'm going to talk about how to make a PDF typable for free. Now, whether you freelance, you're making something for a client, an email list, or even yourself, making a PDF totally writable is a huge advantage. And you're going to need two things today to make this work. You're going to need access to canva.com and access to pdfescape.com. All right, stick around, it's gonna be a great video. Hey guys, so for this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to make something writable, and I'm gonna show you using a PDF that I recently made writable for our subscribers. So right now, if you go to remoteworkguides.com, our website, and you subscribe, you get a free end-of-year planner that's gonna help you map out financial goals, business goals, how to make your business run better, faster, more efficiently, and blogging content goals so that you can plan out your entire 2018's worth of posts. And I wanted this to be writable for our subscribers, because if it's not writable, what's the point of reading it? So I'm just gonna show you real quick, tongue twister, what that looks like. So, you know, I've made this particular document in Canva, and then using PDF Escape, I made it writable. So now if you go to your goals, you can physically type in your own goals and how you're going to achieve that plan of action. And something that I like to do that I recommend you do as well is you make every writable section a different color so that it's more intuitive. And I'll show you in a little bit what I mean and just how to achieve this look. All right, so if you have a document of your own, go ahead and follow along with me. Let's go over to canva.com, and obviously you need an account for this. Fortunately, Canva is free. So I'm in my canva.com. This is exactly where I made my end of year planner. I'm just gonna pop this open so we can kind of walk through real quick. All right, wait for this to load. So I mentioned, I think it's a good idea to put a different color behind any space that you want to make typable. The reason being, if you have just a white blank space and then you go over to pdfescape.com, you make it writable, PDF Escape doesn't change the color or it doesn't add a border, so it's not really intuitive. You know, if you just give somebody a blank white piece of document, it's not really that intuitive like where they should type. So rather than make people second guess where they need to be clicking, I recommend adding a different color box. So it's actually quite simple to add a box. You actually come over here to elements on the left-hand side and click on shapes. And there you'll find a variety of shapes. I think the typical square is a pretty good one. By default, it's gonna come up pretty large and black. So you're just gonna resize your square. You can rotate it if you need to. Whatever size shape you want. And again, this is going to be the area that is typable for somebody else. So once you're happy with your shape, you can change the color. I opted for a light blue just because we use this blue color on our website a lot. If you're happy with this color, great. I like to make it a little transparent so that it's not like in your face blue. So you can come up here to the transparency bar and just toggle that to basically whatever percentage of transparency you want. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of that. So let's pretend like you've added boxes where you want people to type and you're ready to go. You can simply download your document, and I'll go ahead and just download the whole thing. And as we're waiting for that, I do wanna mention that PDF Escape is great because it is free. I think it's the best tool that I've found for free online so far. But I will mention this. If you have a large document, like this document that I'm downloading right now is 8 pages. The pictures are huge. It's an enormous PDF. If you have something that's too large, PDF Escape is going to try to make you pay for an account. Don't do it. In fact, in 3 seconds when this finally downloads, I'm going to show you how to get around that paid only account on PDF Escape. So just bear with me 1 second. All right, so the file finally downloaded. It's huge. I'm simply just gonna drag this onto my desktop. And then I'm gonna come over here to PDF Escape. You know what, I can close Canva altogether because we are done with it. So now that we're at pdfescape.com, like I said, if you have a big document and you try to drag it in here, it's going to say your upload's way too big. Please upgrade or pay us. Now, normally I would say, yes, go for it, pay for things. But if overhead is tight or if you don't use this that often, I'll show you how to get around this. So if I open up my actual document, there are only 3 of the 8 pages that I actually need typable. I'm not editing the homepage. I'm not editing any of these tips and tools and links. I'm just making this particular financial goal planning page writeable. So what I like to do, and if you have a PC, I'm sorry to say, I don't know if this works the same for you, but I'm using a Mac and this is preview. So what I like to do is grab the page that you want to make writeable and just drag it. Just drag it out of this document altogether. You can even delete the original, and I'll show you why in a second. So we're just going to minimize that. Let's see. Here is our dragged financial planning page. And you're just going to drag this into PDFEscape. Now, if you don't have a huge, enormous PDF and you're just, you know, you are just making one page editable, you don't need to worry about any of this dragging nonsense. Just upload that one page that you're making writable into PDFEscape. So this is what it's going to look like once your document has been uploaded onto the website. And there are only a couple things we're actually going to finagle with. So first and foremost, as you can see, we have our kind of light blue outline. And again, this is a great guideline for you to know where to make something typable, and it just makes it more intuitive when somebody actually downloads your document and is going to type on it. So what you're going to want to do is come over here to Freeform, and you have a couple options here. You can text, which is just one single line of text, text paragraph. This is a good option if you have a large space for somebody to type. If you intend for them to use the space to type multiple lines, tons of paragraphs, this is the option for you. Checkbox, pretty intuitive. It's to add a check mark. Drop down is a good one. To be honest, I've actually never used the submit or reset buttons, but all good options for you to explore. But to make something just kind of straightforward writable, make sure you have this text selected and then click select. Now what we're going to do is just put your cursor over this light blue, again, great guideline, and you're going to click and you're going to drag. This is exactly where your writeable box is going to go. And as you can see, it's highlighted in green. When you download and save this document, you won't see the green color. This is just for you. And there are a couple other things that you can finagle with at this point. You can change the font. So you can come up here and choose from a limited variety of fonts, but I think Arial is fine. And you can change the font size. I actually find for these big PDFs 12 to be a little small. So I tend to default to 14, 15, 16. I just think it's a better size, but you can play with that as well and find the one that's appropriate for you. You can change the font color so that when somebody types, they can type in a gray, in a whatever color of the rainbow you want them to type in, they can do it. And oops, if you accidentally click like I just did, you can delete this box. Just come up here to the trash can and click delete. And you're going to repeat that. So I know it can be a little tedious, but you're going to repeat this until all of your fields are selected. And you know, I wish there was an easier way, but if you want to do something right, it takes time. So let's just say I've gone through and I've now made all of these individual boxes writable. What you're going to do is come over here to the green arrow. This is your download button, and you're going to click it. It's going to save, and it's going to download for you. You can just drag this on your desktop and, of course, give it a whirl. Make sure it's exactly set up how you wanted it to be. But as you'll see here, the two boxes that we made in PDFEscape are writable, and nothing else is. So, yeah, it's a really handy tool. I think it's very simple. And again, I think this is the best tool that's out there for free online right now. And I'll finish up with this. If you, like me, had a multi-page document that was too big and you've ended up dragging and dropping individual pages and then you need to know how to put it back together, it's very simple. So let's open our original giant PDF thing. And if you recall, we had our writeable financial goals page right after this this financial write-up, for lack of better words. All you're going to do is drag that writeable document from your desktop right into the packet again, and you'll see it's, did I drag the wrong one? I dragged the wrong one. This is what happens when you have way too many documents. No, I didn't. I dragged the right one. Ooh. There we go. Wow. I dragged the right one, and now it is writeable. So that's all you're going to do. You're going to repeat the process. You know, you'll drag your next page out. You'll delete it from your original packet. You'll make it writeable, and then you'll drag it back in. And that's it. I hope you found value in this video. I hope you could follow along. And if you use a tool that you prefer online, drop us a comment below, because I'm always looking for the next best thing. And don't forget to subscribe for more great videos. And of course, if you head over to remoteworkguides.com right now, you too will get your very own writeable end of the year planner to help you map out and rock 2018. All right, until the next one, see you later.